Welcome to the 2017 Mr. and Miss North Carolina A&T Pageant, a night with Motown. Sit back, relax, and enjoy a Marcus Ferby and the Student Senate production. We present to you our hosts for the evening, Dominique Williams and Asha Duniani.
Time when the height of the music industry was here in Motown Records, Hicksville, USA. Your mission this evening is to get your groove on, baby, because when we out here grooving the way we grooving and you moving the way you moving, it is the quintessential experience of experiences. The thought for the evening is happiness, the mood for the night is love, and when you get them together, flip the script, you got some love and happiness. Make you want to come home early, stay out all night, make you want to do wrong and do right. So sit back and relax, because this is an evening with Motown. Did you get the basket I sent over for you? Oh, you don't like fruit?
I told you.
Hush up. No, yeah, I got your message. Today. Yeah. You can trust me, Mr. Gordy. My name is Dominique Nico Williams, and if I say it's gonna get done, it... Hello?
He hung up on you, didn't he?
No. He told me he had to leave and politely hung up the phone. I said, what am I gonna do? Upper management says I need to sign 6 more people by the end of tonight.
Well... Nico, here's a stack of applicants right here. They've been sending in their information for ages now.
It's gonna take me years to go through all of that. I need 6 people tonight. That's 3 guys and 3 girls. Lord Jesus, I'm gonna lose my job.
Ain't got no wife.
Ain't got no little Nico's running around.
We'll have a talent search tonight.
No, I got it. We'll have a Motown talent search tonight.
But I just said that.
No, but I said Motown talent search tonight. The gesture makes it different. Oh, and the finalists might even have a chance to run for Mr. and Mrs. North Carolina A&T.
Oh, and we can judge them in 3 different categories. Talent, oratory, and a question and answer section.
Asha, you are a genius. I knew I was doing something right when I hired you as my secretary.
No. I'm your administrative assistant. You gotta get it right, Nico.
But of course. And before we get to any of those other events, we need to know who's who. So you tell the people to get ready, because here we come. You see what I just did there right there? Because that's the name of the song we just sang. You must not have got it. It's okay.
No, I got it. It just wasn't funny.
What about the judges?
Oh, we already have them picked out. They're right here on the front row. After the contestants introduce themselves, you'll hear the judges' bios on the sound system. We're already ready and set to go.
You on it, okay? I see you. Tell them to come on out. We want to see who we got.
All right, now this is a talent audition. We're looking for the top three girls and the top three guys. You make it in, and you might just have the opportunity of becoming Mr. and Miss A&T. But I ain't making no promises.
Do anything just to shake you. But how strong you stand determines what will last. Good evening, Aggies. It is now time for us to raise the standard and be a cut above. My name is Quishun Jenkins, a junior psychology student from Rocky Mount, North Carolina, known as the 2-5. The evening has just begun. Sit back, relax, for I'm your contestant number one.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Good evening, Aggies. I am DreShaun Jarmon, Jr., Management Information System student from the City of Brotherly Love, Philadelphia. Now watch me do what I do. I am your contestant number two.
The measure of a king is not by the sparkle in his crown or the majesty of his throne, but in his ability to lead and serve his peers with integrity, transparency, and perseverance. A junior, journalism and mass communication student, concentrated in public relations from Durham, North Carolina. I am Emmanuel Gbedee, and I stand before you humbly in quest of becoming the ninth Mr. North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University, firmly mounted on the platform of prestige and rich legacy, the few, the proud, the Aggies. And I am your contestant number 3. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and judges. I am Ryan Anthony Godwin, a junior candidate for a Bachelor of Arts degree in psychology, hailing all the way from the City of Champions, Cleveland, Ohio. Do not worry, do not fret, for there is more to come. I am your contestant number 4.
Dudley, a junior psychology student from the City of Dream, Fayetteville, North Carolina, also known as the 2-6, and I am and I am your contestant number 2.
Because we are magic doesn't mean that we aren't real. It's time to redefine black royalty. Good evening. I am Simone Renee Nicholson, a rising senior industrial and systems engineering student hailing all the way from Charm City, Baltimore, Maryland. God-fearing, loving, and free, I am your contestant number 3. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and honorable judges. My name is Aniya Lee Bradsher, a rising senior earning a Bachelor of Psychology degree, hailing from Burlington, North Carolina, and I am your Miss North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University contestant number 4. Thank you.
When the power of love overcomes the love of power, the world will know peace. Good evening. My name is Jennifer Wilson, a junior professional theater student from Atlanta, Georgia. I stand on the platform against all odds. People can't help what families they're born into or what circumstances they have, but if they put in the work physically, spiritually, and mentally, they can become the rose that grows out of the concrete. Sit back and relax, because the time has arrived for you to meet your contestant number 5.
Now introducing the judges of the evening. Miss Tiffany Brown. Miss Tiffany Brown is a native of Greensboro, North Carolina, and a 2002 graduate of North Carolina A&T State University with a bachelor's in history. She also holds a Master of Public Administration from North Carolina State University. Miss Brown currently works for the City of Greensboro Human Resources Department as the Manager of Learning and Development and is a nationally certified professional in learning and performance. Ms. Brown has been the head coach and director of the Golden Delight Auxiliary for 17 seasons. She worked closely with the director of bands to generate the overall vision, marketing, strategic direction, and leadership development of the ensemble. Her performance experience includes over 25 years of dance, twirling, vocal ensembles, and competitive pageants. Tiffany is a member of Tau Beta Sigma National Honorary Band Sorority Incorporated, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, and several HR professional organizations. Ms. Brown adjuncticates competitions nationally and serves as a mentor for high school and HBCU dance coaches. Her true passion is working with individuals and groups to help them reach their full potential. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Tiffany Brown. Please stand and be recognized. Ms. Nicole Pride. As a chief staff at North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University, Nicole Pride is the principal liaison and senior advisor to the chancellor, is a member of the chancellor's executive cabinet, and provides strategic and operational support for internal and external constituencies. Pride joined North Carolina A&T in August 2010 as the associate vice chancellor for university relations, serving as the university's chief communications officer and responsible for communications, marketing, branding, media and public relations, and crisis communications. I present to you Ms. Nicole Pride. Please stand to be recognized. Mr. Zeb Talley III. Mr. Zeb began his career as a 20-year-old college graduate. He possesses over 15 years of experience in education, human resources, training and development, and administrative fields. With a lifetime of experience serving and assisting nonprofit and charitable organizations during his tenure as a professional, he's been privileged to partner with and directly support several Fortune 100 and 500 companies in a variety of capacities, focusing his efforts mainly in the areas of recruitment and retention, corporate staffing, staff/student development, and leadership training. He currently serves as the assistant to the Chief of Staff in the Office of the Chancellors here at North Carolina A&T State University. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Zeb Talley III. Dr. Judy Rashid. Dr. Judy Rashid served as the advisor to Miss North Carolina A&T and the Royal Court for 19 years. She was the founding campus advisor for Miss A&T in the NBCA Hall of Fame Queens competition held annually in Atlanta. She also served as advisor to the Student Government Association for 12 years, during which time she supported the Student Senate to successfully gain approval from the university and the Board of Trustees for the position of the first Mr. North Carolina A&T. During her tenure as a university administrator for 25 years, Dr. Rashid received many awards and recognitions, most notably in 2013, former Miss A&T, spanning 50 years, returned to campus to bestow upon her the first Miss A&T Legacy Award. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Judy Rashid. Dr. Kenneth Ruff. Kenneth Ruff is the Director of University Bands at North Carolina A&T State University. His band duties include directing the marching band, wind ensemble, symphonic band, and pep band. Additional duties within the music program at A&T include directing the university flute choir, saxophone choir, clarinet choir, and teaching applied flute lessons. Ruff holds a bachelor's degree in music education and master's degree in educational administration and supervision from North Carolina A&T State University. He also holds a master's degree in music education a specialist degree in education, and a doctorate in education from the University of North Carolina at Greensboro. Prior to becoming the director of university bands at North Carolina A&T State University, Ruff served as an assistant principal at Eastern Guilford High School. Ruff served as a director of bands at Eastern Guilford High School and McLennisville Middle School, and an associate director of bands at John Moly Moorhead High School and Holmes Middle School in Eden, North Carolina. Ruff is a member of Phi Mu Alpha Sinfonia Professional Fraternity of Music, Kappa Kappa Psi National Honorary Band Fraternity, Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, and Tau Beta Sigma National Honorary Band Fraternity. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Kenneth Ruff. And now for our auditors, Ms. Helen Buck. Helen Buck is an alumna and also a graduate of the University of North Carolina at Greensboro, where she received her master's degree in accounting. She is a certified public accountant and currently serves as the director of accounting here at North Carolina A&T State University. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Helen Buck. Mr. Scott, a certified public assistant, serves as A&T's Associate Vice Chancellor for Business and Finance and Comptroller of UNC Chapel Hill. He is a graduate of UNC, where he received a bachelor's degree in mathematics and psychology, a master's degree in math teaching, and an MBA in finance. Humo has been an Aggie for 31 years now, but prior to coming to A&T, he was on the audit staff of the Big Six accounting firm of Peak Marwick, now KPMG. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Scott Humo. And last but not least, Dr. Kevin James. Dr. James serves as chairperson of the Department of Accounting and Finance. He is a graduate of the University of Tennessee, where he received his doctorate degree in accounting. He also holds an MBA from Middle Tennessee State University and is a certified public accountant. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Kevin James. And now, for your entertainment, Ms. Gabrielle Ramsor.
See you, it is on. Ooh.
We need some more talent like that right there in Motown. What's her name?
Gabby Ramshire.
She gonna blow up. You better say that name. I'm trying to tell you. Listen, now, we've got some beautiful ladies and gentlemen, great potential, lots of great choices. And now that we know who they are, we need to know what's inside their head. Because we don't want just a pretty face if it ain't nothing inside their heads.
Okay, well, the next category is oratory, but I think we need to see the men again for this section. I mean, well, we had an interview with the women beforehand, and I'd just like to see the men again.
Fine with me, fine with me. That's less work on me. I'm thinking we'll give them an oratory topic and 3 minutes to respond.
Okay.
They exceed the 3 minutes, and we'll take some points off their final score. The topic should be, what did they think when David Ruffman left the Temptations? Because I know I was kind of hurt. I was walking around to
Nico, Nico, I think we need to have a topic that's more relevant in today's society.
Okay, okay.
What about, am I a relevant change agent in my community?
I like it. We'll go with that. Let's go with that.
Okay.
All right, you tell the first one to get ready, okay? Let's go.
Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number one, Quishun Jenkins.
In my bag here, I have a foolproof method that will be used to control the black slaves. I guarantee every one of you that if it is installed correctly, we will control the slaves for the next 300 years, at least. Since birth, I have been deemed as nothing more than a menace to society. And that rings to be true because African-American men have the lowest literacy rate among any other culture. And we ask ourselves, we have become publicly known for our physical attractions. So we've been all, in essence, become strong in the body, but yet weak in the mind. We ask ourselves, how good are we? We've become so good at acting that we've acted our way back into the plantation. Oh my, how the Huxtables have fallen. When asked if I am a relevant change agent within my community, my response is simple. I choose to be happy, and I choose to be black. In spite of everything that is going on around me, I still smile. In spite of what tomorrow looks like, I still smile. Smiling for me has become the most revolutionary thing that I know to do. Because when I smile, I kill them with kindness. When this black man walks into the room, my presence alone demands respect. Willie Lynch said it best, at least he thought. So when you ask me if I'm a relevant change agent within my community, Jesse Williams said it best. Just because we are magic does not mean that we are not real. Willie Lynch does not have anything on this brother. I still encourage every young brother I come in contact with. I tell him to be better. I tell him to be wise in his decision making. I tell every brother I know to treat a lady with respect. Yes, chivalry is not dead. I tell her when I come in contact with, it is okay to be better than the next. But the only time I believe we should put our hands on each other, that is when we are putting our hands to fix each other's crown. Hold your head up high. You were born to lead. It's not enough just to survive, but we must thrive. So thirdly, if asked if I'm a relevant change agent within my community, I find myself becoming puzzled because I wonder how. Then I answer, I am a change agent in my community because my actions speak a lot louder than my words. Thank you.
Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number two, DreShaun Jarmon.
Dre, get down.
I can still hear it so loud and clearly. We ran around the corner and there he was, lifeless.
not even in high school yet, and here I am looking at another black male shot and killed through senseless violence. You see, these types of things, some people only see on the news. But for me, I saw it all the time. And it wasn't until that very moment that I knew a change had to come. He was another statistic, just another young black male dead. I knew I was not going to let my environment, my community, or even America make me into another statistic. It was my duty to break the generational curse. So, am I a relevant change agent in my community? Am I like Martin, that went against the grain and like a phoenix emerged as a male leader impacting the lives of thousands? Am I like Malcolm, forcibly demanding that America pay attention to my brilliance? Am I like Stokely, striking the similarities of the Pan-African movement and the plight of the American Negro? In so many ways, yes, I am. I am change. How? Because change starts from within. And when I was able to do that, I was able to impact the kids in my community. You see, it's not often that you go and you do these types of things. I live for the moments when young kids tell me they want to be as good as me. I tell them that it is our job to defy the statistics. Who said we can achieve? Who said we cannot go as far as our minds can take us? Who said that? They? They are not the author and finisher of our faith. They did not create us in a likeness of their image. They have no authority over our lives. Therefore, we will make it. At a young age, I knew that my life was so much bigger than me. It wasn't about being in the local newspaper or the local news, but about a young black boy with no father. A young black boy that didn't know self-love because he was abused. A young black boy that was so afraid to follow his dreams because everything seemed so impossible. For every situation, obstacle, this young black boy made it. So change agent, yes I am. Yes. My change started from within. And when it did, I was able to impact my generation and my community. I want to continue to be the light for the people in Philadelphia by continuing with the legacy of Mr. A&T that has been so inspirational. It has been a position that encouraged young men to rise up and realize their royalty. So students, no matter the situation, no matter the past, no matter the present, let go of the days in your life. Take it from me, a young black boy from South Philadelphia that has and forever will be a powerful change agent in my community. Thank you.
Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number 3, Emmanuel Gbedee.
Isn't it ironic that my home is the birthplace of a revolution? I was born in Monrovia, Liberia in 1996. The foundation of Liberia is a direct result of racial prejudice. In 1822, Liberia was founded by the American Colonization Society. During this time, the Colonization Society believed that sending American slaves back to Africa would free them of racial hardships. Liberia simply means land of the free, similar to its counterpart, the United States of America. However, in 2002, Liberia faced a civil war which lasted for 2 years. As a result of the civil war, I moved to America in 2004 at the age of 7 years old. My arrival allowed me the opportunity to benefit from my environment, given the opportunity for a better education, being able to live, learn, and adapt to another culture. I have taken advantage of the educational advancement available in America, attending an HBCU, North Carolina A&T State University, has allowed me to appreciate not only my black culture, but my roots. And here we are in 2017, where the current political climate ostracizes refugees. Those that are looking for a sanctuary are now being told that America cannot be their safe haven, the same land of the free that accepted me. What makes my situation different from those currently? How can we call ourselves the land of the free? Is this our way of making America great again? As a benefactor of outstanding circumstances, I have taken the chance through the Liberian Association of North Carolina. I have made it my duty to spark change in the life of someone else. So through the Liberian Association of North Carolina, I was able to fortunately raise school supplies and I was able to fortunately help raise school supplies and school materials to local grade schools in my country. My family and I have also made it a point to remain active change agents in our country. Over the years, we sent home several boxes of clothing items to those in need. So throughout my adolescence, I have made it a point to distinguish myself from the urban tribe. I am an African refugee. I am a scholar, and I am Emmanuel Gbedee. So while the government is building up walls, I am building up my community. Thank you.
Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number 4, Ryan Godwin.
Oh, wonderful change has come over me. Am I a relevant change agent in my community? This question made me think of who I used to be. Tonight's prompt made me think of the relevant change that God first had to do in me. If you would allow me to be transparent for a minute, much like many of you, I'm just the first to admit it, but I struggle with being good enough. Tonight's question took me back to a time when I wondered if I was even a relevant change agent within myself. All those nights I lied awake wondering if I was still good enough to receive God's grace and love when often I treated him like the dust that he created me from. Unsatisfied, trying, searching, and longing to be fulfilled on the inside, it was then that I realized that in all of my games and selfishness, God was still displaying selflessness, and I had to change. Step 1, love others. If I wanted to be the catalyst for change, I had to love those around me like they were my brother, my sister, my responsibility, trusting and supporting unconditionally. 2, connect with purpose. If I want to stimulate change in myself and others, I must do so with purpose, precision, and persistence. 3, build community. The sooner we all realize that we do it better when we do it together is when we will all become the stimulus for change. It is not about individual talent, but a combination of factors, expanding our capacities while anticipating the next step. 4, learning is the work. If I can think it, then I can do it. And if I can believe it, then I can achieve it. And if we want to make relevant change, then knowledge is the answer. And we must create a culture that supports lifelong learning. 5, be transparent. No one is perfect. Do not hide behind flaws, but embrace them. Think of them as a new task to overcome and a new obstacle to tackle. 6, make this all a cycle. Do not take for granted this opportunity to be the change that you want to see, but embrace these pearls of wisdom and give them to somebody else so that in a dark place their light may shine as bright as ours, so that instead of generational curses, we create generational blessings. If someone is more fortunate than you, then I charge you to build a longer table and not a taller fence. Truly, excellence is the process of becoming better than we all once were. Change, change, change. I'm so glad he changed me. Thank you.
Some really good things going on today. I love what's going on. But listen, I need to use the bathroom and relieve myself. I'll be right back.
Motown Records Office of Dominique Williams. This is Asha speaking. Oh, hey, Keisha girl.
Nah, Nico went to the restroom. I can talk.
Mm-hmm. Oh, girl, no, he didn't. Okay, well, look, listen to this. I got a call from Stax Records. Yes, girl, Stax Records. And they offered me a job. Yes, girl. Yes. They heard of how good of an administrative assistant I was and wanted to offer me a job. Yeah. They were willing to pay me more money and actually call me an administrative assistant. Girl, I was almost on the phone like this right here, look. Hello? Stack Records? Oh, yes, this is she. You want to offer me a job? More money? More benefits? Oh,
Yes, I'll take the job. Of course I'll take the
Lord
job.
Lord Jesus, Asha gonna leave me. Lord Jesus.
I need to come back. I'm
gonna
call you back. Okay.
This is the best administrative assistant I've ever had.
Nico, what's wrong with you? Nico, what's wrong with you?
Lord Jesus.
Nico, come on. We ain't got time for this. We got to move on, baby.
Move on. Oh, Lord Jesus.
Not what I meant, Nico. Come on. We got to get ready for the talent portion.
Talent. Yeah. That's right. We're not going to sign nobody unless they got no talent.
Exactly.
So let's get to it. Okay.
Moving on to our talent portion. Please welcome Miss A&T contestant number one, Summer Bracey.
To carry a secret is to play with fire. Try to pass it on, and you risk hurting someone else. Hold on to it, and eventually, you get burned. This is my untold story.
You left me. You really left me. Every night, I stop and I ask myself, God, why did you allow this to happen to me? I know it was in God's will, but was it in His will for me to have this void? Moving into college, watching other parents move their children in, I witnessed parents saying their goodbyes, but you had already said your goodbye to me. You were supposed to be there, to embrace me in your arms when things went wrong, but you left me. God, I can still hear your cries of pain and agony. And somehow I selfishly still want you here with me. But you left me. But here we are. That was then. And this is now. I've matured and I've grown, and I can now say, I am Summer Bracey. Mama, you didn't leave me. You are always right here with me. And when I walk through the campus of North Carolina A&T State University, I am not alone, because I can feel your warmth and presence surrounding me. See, it's your spirit that keeps me alive, because you taught me through all your struggles and pain that I can be a queen. I can serve. I can do all things. You told me, the scripture, Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Mama, these are the things that you taught me. You taught me that if there was a problem, I can solve it. See, as I look in the crowd tonight, I don't see your face, but I can feel you. I can feel your presence with me here today. If there's a disease, I can cure it. If there's a patient, I can save it. If there's a child, I can love and embrace it. Mama, these are the things that you taught me. Mama, you may have lost the battle of cancer, but I still fight against all odds for you. I am Summer Bracey, and this is my story.
Please welcome Miss A&T contestant number two, Ashli Dudley.
What you want from me?
What you want from me?
And just to get close to you and burn something today. And I'll run for miles just to get a taste.
Welcome, Miss A&T contestant number 3, Simone Nicholson.
Did he make you forget your own name? Did he convince you he was a god? Did you get on your knees daily? Do his eyes close like doors? Are you a slave to the back of his head? Am I talking about your husband or your father?
Caged bird sings. I roared myself out of fear of being alone until I realized you weren't even worth it. Staring me in my eyes, his more fabricated than ever. Although my eyes closed, I could taste the dishonesty on his lips when he kissed me after saying I love you. My spirit swifting from my body because this ride of tragedy was sucking the life out of me, limb by limb, my whole flesh and soul trapped into his mildewed sheets. The room had me feeling like the dead walking amongst the living, trying to stay stable instead of this official, artificial love that was barely hanging on by a thread. His poor attempt to love me had me yearning for more than just a warm spot in bed at night, but I guess it never occurred to him that his lack of affection turned me off when he was stuffing his unmentionables through me. Trying to stay stable, I opened the door and I felt the sun on my face. It was like crawling out of hell. And I was done playing with the demons, begging and pleading to ask God, why is he forsaking me? But the thought of me being completely out of your life stroked my heart each time it even popped into my mind, because this world won't love you the way I do. Who is going to be there for you when America lynches you with its flag? But you'd rather be her nigga than be my king, except at nighttime, because that's the only time my black girl magic is recognized. 3 years since I've been in your presence, I am finally able to regain a sense of who I am. I am the juxtaposition of what some of these white women wish to be and what anything less than a king can no longer have. Ladies, we continuously give so much to ourselves of men unworthy of even a peace, a simple hello and goodbye. Therefore, we find ourselves drained before we can properly give to a man who will treat us like the queen we are. We are worthy of something so much greater than ourselves, precious like pearls, God-fearing, beautiful, and so you must no longer let anyone or anything give you less, because Miss Angela once explained, we delight in the beauty of the butterfly, but rarely amid the changes it's gone through to achieve that beauty. I, a butterfly shedding this scarlet letter off, let me be free from the enslavement of your love, treating me as if I was this fugitive. Let me be a linkfish.
Please welcome Miss A&T contestant number 4, Aniya Bradsher.
My mom tied my hair up in bows. I wore leotards as clothes and spent hours learning to point
my toes. It was the first time I was aware of my blackness, considering I was in a room full of pink and whiteness where the difference was already being taught because all we did was fall. The first time I felt unique was in middle school, where the boys in my grade teased me for the grade of my hair. And at the time, I really did seem to care, but soon after, I realized I was just rare. I felt like a sight to see, and oh, that was the first time confidence was instilled in me. Now, this was a feeling that I had yet to feel, and it was oh so real, confidence. It makes you feel powerful beyond belief. That is, until it is ripped out from underneath your feet by a society telling you that you must compete because you're good is never good enough. However, comparison to me is a sin because it is the death of self-love within. But what if the black woman knew she would be desired by others only if she desired herself, and that beauty is not a shade but a mindset, and the best indicator of it is self-confidence. Women, carry your worth more prestigious than fine stones. We are the landmarks of triumph, integrity, humility, and beauty, never to be merely reduced as something enticing to the male eye, but to implant power and poise to bring our men up from boys. A woman is a portal for life, and that is a sight to see. Therefore, take me seriously. Matter of fact, take us seriously. Love us seriously, because I am more than the arch in my back, the sun of my smile, the ride of my breast, and the grace of my style. Maya Angelou, I too am a phenomenal woman, phenomenally, intellect running over, abundantly, roots nappy, and unapologetically a black woman. But yet and still you won't give me real love. I ask that you love me because I am the diamond under the pressure of oppression. I realize I am a queen. What a transgression, considering the TV screen epitomizes beauty as something that looks nothing like me. But hear my cry. Understand that our vision is distorted because still we are the unloved. Still we are the oppressed, but I digress. You are the same black that's been under attack for countless years. At this point, you know no limits and you have no fears. You are the same woman that was ordered to be seen and not heard. However, you demanded this attention that demanded this difference. Though it has never been respected, it has been paid for with great sacrifice. Therefore, it will suffice. I am your equal. I am not your competitor, but you will take me seriously. Thank you.
Please welcome Miss A&T contestant number 5, Jennifer Wilson.
Ever since I was created in the cradle of humanity, I've always been running. My legs designed with speed, my body made with muscle, my eyes on the prize, I was ready for the hustle. But they tried to capture me in the crest of my nest in the home of humanity, not because they were extremely lazy, but because they knew we were stronger and we could run for longer. So yes, I've been running. I survived a journey that shouldn't have left me alive in a country where I thrive. So they bound my body up in chains and tried to bind me by my brains so I couldn't think and just do what needed to be done. So I couldn't run away. I could simply run and run and run. But you see, I am the black spirit. And there is a piece of me in every one of you. Can't you hear it in your heartbeat?
Yaro, 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 yaro.
So no, I haven't been running away from things. I have been running things. My eyes formed for foresight, my mind envisioned for ingenuity, my thick lips ideal for forming words that can change the world, my even thicker hips molded by black beauty to bring forth life. I am the black spirit. am. It is who I will be. They tried to hold me down, but I will always be free. So as vessels that hold the essence of civilization, there are some things you need to know. You are not chains. You are not pain. You are not an unruly stain in the fabric of America. You are not gangs. You are not violence. You are not silence. You are the foundations of all that ever was and all that will ever be. I am. You are. We are. The black spirit. Yaro, yaro.
Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number one, Quishun Jenkins.
They gon' love me for my ambition. Easy to dream a dream, but what's harder to live?
Good morning, Ms. Lee.
Good morning, Chancellor Jenkins.
How are you today?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you.
You're
it speaks for itself.
Beautiful music, paint a picture, this is my
ambition. My ambition to win, just to get me some ends. Help me pay my little rent, maybe sit in the bins. I saw mama praying as she wait on.
Greetings, Aggie family. It brings me great pleasure to serve as your chancellor. I want to continue to challenge you all to raise the standard a cut above.
Wow. Wow. And to think that almost never happened. I almost didn't get the chance to become the chancellor of North Carolina A&T State University. You see, I am he who almost never was. I almost didn't get to see the light of day. You see, I remember growing up as a child, struggling to know my purpose, struggling to find my purpose, reading all of these books. Then one day, I heard this story. See, my mom at the age of 18 is a senior in high school. She becomes in love. She falls in love with a guy so charming and so magnificent in all his ways. He shows her a better way to life. He chose to choose my mother as his one to be. My mom made him her knight in shining armor. She fell in love with this guy. Then they went to prom together. But then one thing happened on prom night. They concluded the night with making passionate love with each other. And then she becomes pregnant. For some people, that may be the best news you've heard all year. But for others, that may be your worst nightmare. Could you imagine the semester before leaving for college, the second one in your family to go to college, you become pregnant? What are you gonna do? My mom freaks out. She asks my grandmother what she should do. My dad immediately takes the blame for it being his fault. So with that being said, my mother then moves on, contemplating, what am I gonna do? But then my mother has a thought, I can't do this. My grandmother tells my mom, you can't afford to abort your destiny. I am he who almost never was. So I want to first say, thank you, Mama, for enduring the embarrassment when the people treated you funny. Thank you, Mama, for staying strong when your educators looked at you with their eyes filled with judgment. Thank you, Mama, for staying motivated to get that degree. The most expensive piece of paper you'll ever buy is that degree. Thank you, Mama. I love you.
Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number two, DreShaun Jarmon.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't the honeymoon. We passed the infatuation phase. Right in the thick of love, it times we get sick of love. It seems like we argue every day. I know I misbehaved and you made your mistakes, and we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurt, I still put you first, and we'll make this thing work. But I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go, 'cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. This time we'll take it slow. This ain't no movie, no. No fairy tale conclusion, y'all. It gets more confusing every day. Sometimes it's heaven sent, then we head back to hell again. We kiss, then we make up all the way. I hang up, you call. We rise and we fall, and we feel like just walking away. As our love advances, we take second chances. Though it's not a fantasy, I still want you to stay. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go, oh, 'cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow, slow. This time we'll take it slow.
We want to recognize some special guests in the audience tonight. All former Mr. and Miss A&T, including Miss Crystal Williams, Jamal Averett, and Myja Gary, please stand to be recognized. And any other Mr. and Miss former A&Ts. Former VPIA Isaiah Ginyard, who was the author of the legislation that created this pageant, we would like to recognize him as well. Peace to the left. Thank you. Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number 3, Emmanuel Gbedee.
They went down, and what did they find? They found limbs and heads strewn all over the place. And then after that, in my neighborhood, all of the men organized themselves into an armed patrol. They had to take their guns and patrol our community every night because they did not want that to happen again. I mean, that's why when someone asked me about violence, I just find it incredible. What it means is that the person who's asking that question has absolutely no idea what black people have gone through, what black people have experienced in this country since the time the first black person was kidnapped from the shores of Africa.
You see, on the surface, crime and punishment appears to be an unsophisticated matter. After all, if a person takes part in a crime, shouldn't he or she suffer the consequences? Right. Crime and punishment are two different problems, stem from racial prejudice justified by an age-old perception and beliefs of African Americans. Here I am, Antoine Smith, 19 years old, locked up in a cell for something that I was falsely accused of. How did I end up here? Growing up in what some may call a white neighborhood, going to what some may call a white high school. How did I end up here? I thought I was doing everything right. Was it the color of my skin? Was it the kinks in my hair? Was it the swagger in my walk? What is the equation that equals a black man going to jail? Black plus male minus college degree times two baby mothers divided by three kids. I've heard that one before. I remember my teacher giving me the statistic that one in three black men will experience prison in his lifetime. I just never thought that would be me. I was simply walking past the store with not a clue as to why I was being stopped, handcuffed. You're under arrest for armed robbery, he said. That scene continues to play in my mind over and over. It's crazy how we've now developed a criminal justice system that is used to maintain the social and economic hierarchy right here in America. So we say thank you. Thank you to public policy. Thank you to white supremacy. Thank you to the criminal justice system. Thank you to society and thank you to the media. You have all played the role in the mass incarceration of us, black men. But there must be a solution to rectify this problem. So my question to you is, where do we go from here? Thank you.
Please welcome Mr. A&T, contestant number 4, Ryan Godwin.
From having been another, as a child is born, from being in a mother's womb. But how many times have you wished you were some other, someone then who you are? Yet who's to say that if all were uncovered, that you would like what you see? You can only be you. I can only be me. Flowers cannot bloom until it is their season, as we would not be here unless it was our destiny. But how many times have you wished to be in spaces, time, places, than what you were? Yet who's to say that with unfamiliar faces that you could anymore be? Loving the you that you see, you can only be you. As I can only be.
For your entertainment, please welcome our current Mr. and Miss A&T Jasmine and Jeffron. Hey.
Pray on just a little while longer. Pray on just a little while. And everything is gonna be all right.
Since 1837, with the founding of the African Institute, Cheney University, historically black colleges and universities have served the underserved, enlightened those kept in darkness, developed those America preferred undeveloped, and protected the people of color this world so often tried to eradicate. Enlighten, develop, protect. These words describe the roots HBCUs have and will continue to have in the black community. Enlighten. Now I ask, what is a tree without proper sunlight or its fruit? The answer is nothing, because fortunately for us, HBCUs provide the enlightenment necessary for its fruits to flourish. Historically black colleges and universities.
These are the only institutions in America that were created for the sole purpose of educating black students. More like a home away from home, a place where we can be free and strangers turn into lifelong friends, family. A home where we, as young educated African Americans, have the opportunity to express our creativity and gain confidence in a world that consistently tries to shackle our brains, engulf our minds, and stifle our success. A Gallup-Purdue University study even finds that black graduates are significantly more likely to have felt supported while in college than black peers who attend predominantly white institutions. Among blacks, 40% of all congressmen.
12.5% of CEOs. 40% of engineers. 50% of lawyers.
And 80% of judges are HBCU graduates. It is no accident that HBCU graduates go on to become prominent figures.
Like the queen of all media, Oprah Winfrey, an alumna from Tennessee State University.
Martin Luther King Jr., a graduate of Morehouse College who lost his life to make sure his dream came true today for all of us. Thurgood Marshall, attending Lincoln University, graduating from Howard University. And our very own Jesse Jackson, civil rights activist, often regarded as one of the most important black leaders, graduating from our institution.
North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University. Protect. As the tree provides shelter from the rain, so does the HBCUs for minorities. Because in a society that constantly shows us that being black could possibly be a death sentence, HBCUs serve as a shield while we work towards the betterment of ourselves. Because in times where police brutality is being filmed by the killings of innocent black men and women, or without speculation or incrimination, HBCUs provide a place where minority students can come together and stand up for social injustice for black men and for women.
It is imperative that as black graduates from these great institutions that we not only succeed, but while we are succeeding, we must serve as catalysts for our communities.
So you know what, Jeff? Now
we challenge you to make a difference in our communities to make sure that our black institutions remain relevant.
He is Jeffron Quadre Smalls.
And she is Jasmine A. Bowles.
And together,
we are your Mr.
and Miss North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University 2016-2017. And we have been the catalysts who have carried the torch thus far.
To make sure that we are producing intellectuals for the next generations.
And so now it is our time to pass the torch to our new royalty. Will you join us?
Thank you.
Yeah, hello, Mr. Gordy. Yes, we're gonna have 6 new people by the end of tonight. I can guarantee you that. Yes, sir. Give me a minute. I'm talking to Mr. Gordy, okay? I said give me a minute. Thank you. Hello? Yes, like I said, I promise you we'll have 6 by the end of tonight. Hey, how about we going golfing on Saturday? No? Sunday afternoon? Hello? Okay. Asha, we gotta get ready for the Q&A. Asha, oh, where you go? Oh, Lord, she done went to Stax Records already, Jesus. Oh, Lord, Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
She's so good to me. Nico, you ready for the Q&A?
The Q&A?
Yes. The
question
and answer session. You ready?
Yes, okay. I am ready. I don't know about you. But I'm ready for the Q&A.
Right here.
All right.
Be right back.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss A&T contestant number 1, Summer Bracey. Reminds me of James Brown. I would sing a song for you, but that ain't my calling. That ain't my ministry. You gotta know yours, okay? Oh, Jesus, Asha, you ain't leave me for real, did you? This song was playing when I first met my first wife. I met her after I met my third wife, and this song was playing. I had a broom in my hand, I was sweeping up. She came up to me. I said, baby, you the best baby I ever had. She said, what about your third wife? I said, not about that right now. We're talking about you. I said, from the first moment I laid eyes on you, I knew that you was gonna be number 1. And then my number 2 called me, and I didn't know what to do. Nevertheless, I don't know about you guys, but I am enjoying tonight's event. You got some beautiful ladies and gentlemen. You all are beautiful. Hey, y'all give her a round of applause.
Hello.
We are ready.
You're fashionably late.
That's what you gotta do,
man. I would like to reintroduce to you all Miss A&T contestant number 1, Miss Summer Bracey. Okay. How about this right here? You should let me get this bowl. Mm-hmm. Say they ready.
Mm-hmm.
We ready. Let's do this thing then.
Okay.
We're gonna reintroduce her a third time, ladies and gentlemen. Miss A&T contestant number one, Miss Summer Bracey. Are young people from single-parent environments at risk more than others who may be from a two-parent home? I'll read it again. Are young people from single-parent environments at risk more than others who may be from a two-parent home?
Thank you for that question. I believe everyone has equal opportunities regardless of the environment that they were raised in. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss A&T contestant number two, Ashli Dudley. Can we keep the doors of HBCUs open?
Thank you for that question. We can keep HBCU doors open by having better alumni support and educating the top 1% Americans, which will be advantages in supporting our HBCUs. Thank you.
Gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please. Please welcome Miss A&T contestant number three, Simone Nicholson. Miss Nicholson, What's your five-year plan look like?
Thank you for that question. Upon graduation, I will be working as an engineer at Tinker Air Force Base on the SMART Scholarship with the Department of Defense, and I will be there for 5 years, earning my master's degree in industrial systems engineering. Thank you.
Welcome, Miss A&T contestant number 4, Aniya Bradsher. Gentlemen, quiet please. Do you believe that everyone is a winner? Why or why not?
I believe that everyone is a winner daily. Everyone in this auditorium is a winner because you woke up this morning and not everybody was afforded that opportunity. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, to all the contestants, just as a reminder, please remember to speak into the mic. Thank you very much. Please welcome Miss A&T contestant number 5, Miss Jennifer Wilson. Miss Jennifer, what has been the greatest challenge in being a student leader, and how have you resolved that issue?
Thank you for that question. The greatest challenge of being a student leader is sometimes reminding my peers that there are things that we have to do that might not always be in their best interest. I only say that because sometimes the lines between friendships and student positions can get blurred. I resolve that by reminding them that I have a job to do, and I will do that to the best of my ability. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen.
That's my favorite part.
Please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number 1, Mr. Quishun Jenkins.
Yeah.
Why should we select you as our title holder?
Thank you for that question. You should select me as your title holder because I would do whatever needs to be done to best represent my dear North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number 2, DreShaun Jarmon. If you could eat with any historical figure from the past, who would it be? What subjects would you cover in conversation?
Thank you for that question. If I could eat with one historical figure, it would be Martin Luther King Jr. Simply because I know it is hard for me to deal with my attitude sometimes, and he dealt with so much adversity, and I would love to know how he was able to stand firm through everything. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number 3, Emmanuel Gbedee. The last book that you read for pleasure, and what was it about?
Thank you for that question. Honestly speaking, the last book that I read for pleasure would have to be my textbook. Attending North Carolina A&T State University, our textbooks are used to experience us and get us knowledge. Thank you for that question.
Ladies and gentlemen.
All right now, y'all.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. A&T contestant number 4, Ryan Godwin.
Yeah.
are your thoughts about the recent election and the temperament of Americans?
Thank you for that question. I believe that this year's past election allowed for people to see America in a more transparent way. We realize people's true thoughts and feelings. And to address the temperament of the country at this time, I believe that we should take our focus off of the national election and focus ourselves on our local and state government. Our local and state government, which would better benefit our lawmaking in our country. Thank you.
Asha! Asha, come here. So listen, I know I haven't been the best boss to you. I could be doing better, like calling you an administrative assistant.
Okay.
I guess what I'm trying to say is I love having you up under me. I mean, what I mean to say is that I love bossing you around.
Nico, okay. Spit it out, baby.
I guess I can show you better than I can tell you. Hit it. I was gonna try to sing, but that's not my calling, so.
Okay.
So the song was, I Want You Back, mm-hmm. from the Jacksons. Mm-hmm. And I want you back, because I know that I heard you on the phone with Stax Records, and I know that you're gonna take the job, but this is my way of saying, stay with me, please.
Nico, no, you misunderstood. I was on the phone with my girlfriend, Keisha. I was telling her how no amount of money could make me wanna leave Motown Records. There's history here.
So you're not leaving me?
No.
Good. Because you are all I need to get by.
Okay, no, don't. You're not about to sing again, are you?
No.
Okay, good, because we gotta keep going.
We gotta keep going.
We have to announce the finalists, baby. Come on.
Now introducing our Mr. and Miss A&T to do their royal walk.
And you know
recognize your current Mr. and Miss A&T State University.
Time is ticking, and Mr. Gordon, okay! Well, all right then, okay. Like I said, time is ticking. Mr. Gordon needs to know who we're signing to Motown Records.
Right, exactly.
But before we get to the finalists, I'd like to call up one of the persons who is most instrumental in putting this whole thing together. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you guys to give him a round of applause, Mr. Marcus Ferby. You know, Mr. Ferby, you know, a wise man once told me.
So, thank you all so much for coming out. Before we get into the results, I want to make sure I call up my Campus Life Committee of the Student Senate. If you all are out there, if you could please come up here. If you're in the back, I know they're everywhere. Here they come.
They're around.
Come on out. Give them a hand, y'all.
This was so not easy to put together,
but I tell you, with the team and with my advisor support, Miss Veronica, where you at? Dr. Bugs, all the special people that made this event possible. Tipping around the auditorium. Oh, there she goes. But yeah, it was great. Thank you all so much for coming out and supporting the Student Government Association. Continue to support us. We definitely put a lot of time and effort into these things for the campus, and we want to make sure we're giving back. We were elected, and we thank you all so much for giving us the opportunity to serve you. So yeah, thank you all so much. Have a good night. After the
Stay lit, stay woke. Yes. So we are now currently awaiting the finalists, so I can keep my job here at Motown Records, so I can get married one day, hopefully soon.
Jesus.
Because you know how, if you ain't got no money, you can't get married.
Look, this day somebody knows.
Somebody knows.
She said yes.
Anyway. You know, y'all are some beautiful people. You're beautiful, gorgeous.
Why are you trying to get out so much? You trying to marry somebody in the crowd?
Say that. She could be out there. How about this? I'm gonna show you that some sound. Right? Way back in the day.
Wait, I don't know what I'm doing. We're going for a smooth spin. Wow.
Yeah.
Wait.
that up.
One day. Your turn.
My turn. You gonna put it in?
I'm gonna put it in the dip.
My back hurt. You got too much. Yes, sir. I remember the first time I heard this song. What I'm gonna do without you. I was lying there in my room. The song was playing there on the radio. She said, Mama, what are they talking about? She said, they talking about love, son. I'm afraid you might not ever experience that. I said, why, Mama? And she looked at me and I looked at her and she said, boy, you your daddy's son. Okay. Are we ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think we have the finalists. But before we do that, we would like the announcer to re-remind the audience how the judging criteria was and how everything was scored. So if we could get that once again.
For the misters, the oratorical speech will be 45%, talent, 35%, evening wear, 10%, and their onstage question, 10%. For the Miss, interview, 45%, talent, 35%, evening wear, 10%, and onstage question, 10%. And as I remind you, their interview was done outside of this pageant beforehand.
On to the finalists. Miss Asha, would you do the honor of introducing the male?
Of course I will. Okay. Now, the winners
We're going to
are...
wait a minute. We're going to wait a minute. Oh. We're going to open the curtains, if you would be so kind.
Sorry, y'all.
And we would like the contestants to all come out, please. Give them a round of applause as they come out.
Presenting the contestants for Mr. and Miss North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University for the 2017-2018 academic school year.
Y'all look so good.
All right.
So now, the winners are...
The finalists are...
For our first finalist, we have Ryan Godwin. DreShaun Jarmon. And for our third male finalist, this is not in any particular order, may I remind you, Quishun Jenkins.
And now for our lovely ladies, the top three finalists, again, in no particular order, we have Miss Aniya Bradsher. Simone Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to remind you all that these are not Mr. and Mrs. A&T. They are simply our finalists. It will be you who decides who is Mr. and Mrs. A&T. And so in order for that to happen, you have got to go out and vote. And the voting will be the last Wednesday in March. And that will be the 29th. The 29th. Ladies and gentlemen, we had a wonderful time. I hope to see you guys the next time.
Attention, everyone. Please leave the auditorium swiftly. We're going to get all pictures outside and during campaign season. Thank you so much for coming out. It's time to go.
Call my name, I'll be there in a hurry. On that you can depend and never worry. Follow the sun wherever it leads. But remember, if you should fall short of your desires, just remember life holds for you one guarantee. You'll always have me. And if you should miss my loving one of these old days, if you should ever miss the arms that used to hold you so close, or the lips that used to touch yours so tenderly, just remember what I told you the day I